Okay, where is he? Just let the skulls do the work for you, meaning they will find him for you. You just keep an eye out on the snakes. That was a close one. Okay, time for a little bit of a reload action. No, he's too fast, you'll never catch him like that. And he's also very sneaky. And because he'll summon those little snakes indefinitely, you just have to... find the right angle. No, no, I'm going too close. That's a trap. So again, don't fall for the stupid traps. Like I said, that was a trap. See? He had two snakes very close to me. Oh, okay, I'm on fire again. Okay, this is the last phase of the fight, so let's go for some submachine gun action. Oh man, that was kind of hard. Ah, yeah. By the way, you can still die if they burn you alive. Who?
Broke a sweat. I'll give you that.
So yeah, the hardest part was just to focus the flying little guy down and then don't fall for his traps. And always use the skull to tell you where he is. And as a side note, yeah, I had to use a lot of fire resistance. And just because I used the Keeper's Ring, the Void Skull Armor, and of course the... I don't have any more of those, but yeah, those are the extinguishers. So if you don't have fire resistance like this, very high 50, you'll probably die. Oh. That was a brutal fight. I mean, this is likely my fifth attempt or something. Oh, okay. Now let's relax a bit. Now let's see. What did he give us? The Zephyr's Conduit. Weapon mod. Well, I guess that's okay. I love weapon modes nonetheless. And there is actually a couple of pots in here. You might want to destroy to get the loot because, you know, loot is always loot. Now, I'll just go back to the base and see what weapon mod we can craft, but in the meantime I'll just patrol this area a bit in case there is something really important here. Well, that's pretty important. Well, I guess this is a very good looting area. Anything up here? Yeah, okay, this is what I'm talking about. Only search the boss fights. The boss area fights, because you might miss a couple of things. I mean, it's not something huge, but, you know, everything adds up. Oh, jackpot. Sorry about the long, you know, looting scenes, but hey, these are important too, you know. This is how you make your game better. By actually earning more money from the fights. Okay, that's nothing, that's nothing. Okay, I also used a couple of ammunition crates. Because sooner or later you'll run out of long ammo. You don't want to fight him with short ammo. Because he's just too agile and he will hide behind corners and snipe you like that. Oh, this is some kind of a ceremonial room, actually. Well, looks like there were some kind of, I don't know, important figures of the tribe. War. Oh well, next time don't mess with the strangers. I guess this is the way I came. So I have to go that way. Yeah, this is a pretty big map. You'll get very easy disoriented on the map. Besides, the boss can be almost anywhere to snipe you, since he has almost unlimited range. And that burning damage, man, you can't avoid being burned to death. So yeah, better have a lot of burning resistance. Okay, looks like I'm on the right path. Well, how do I get there? That's the question. Okay, the game is making me run for it. Oh, I can't go through there. Okay, that's bad. So yeah, as you can see, the game is a lot of surprises. This was a big surprise because this boss is basically a cover shooter boss. Well, maybe except for those snakes. Those are really, really annoying and will destroy your tactic. I already was up there, I think. Yeah, other than that, keep an eye out for the little windows like this, because he will hide a lot in the buildings and then shoot you through the windows. That's what got me a couple of times. I didn't see him shoot me out of the windows. But he also has a tactic where he comes very, very close to you, which is again a problem. Because when he comes very close to you, he'll actually shoot you very fast and you can't dodge. And then he'll just run away and you'll be left fighting the snakes, which is again, not ideal. Not very ideal either. Okay, almost out of ammunition. So where are we? Oh yeah, this is the other path. That tree is beautiful, okay. Enough tree admiring. Enough tree hugging. Let's go back to our base. Okay, let's open the door now. Ooh, the bosses in this area are more interesting than the swamp. And also more interesting than some of the other areas, to be precise. Okay, let's teleport Spock, bring me back to the base. Yeah, at this point you can probably see that you don't get a lot of scrap each level, so if you don't get the Tarnished Ring, so you can use it on Old Regi, so you get the scrap, the scavenger perk, it might be a little very hard for you to get all that scrap you need. 12,000. Hey, don't touch it, don't touch it, get away from that. I guess he just loves the warm feeling of the crystal and the safety of it. Okay, let's see what other weapon mode you can craft with this little thing. Yeah, that definitely will be one of the longer fights in the game.
What now?
As you saw in the last part, he was completely dodging me. Wildfire shot. Fire. Burning, dealing. Well, I guess that's decent.
I've got work to do.
Actually, it's more than decent. I'll have to try that out sooner or later. Yeah, so what that does? 100 fire damage and also ignites them burning. 600 fire damage in 50 seconds. Well, that's actually very, very good. So you might want to use this as your main damage source. Instead of using the fire bullets, you can use this one. It's pretty good. Look at the stats. That's amazing. Anyway, see you next time. Bye. By the way, look at the upgraded weapon. It looks a lot better now. Very high tech. Bye.